गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. आई एम योर न्यू असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर अमित कुमार सिंह फ्रॉम UPRTS स्कूल ऑफ ह्यूमैनिटीज MA इंग्लिश. हियर डिस्कस विथ यू MA इंग्लिश MAEN 101 ब्रिटिश पोएट्री विच इज रिलेटेड विथ मेटाफिजिकल पोएट्स स्पेशली एंड्रू मार्वल एंड हिज पोएम टू हिज क्वायर मिस्ट्रेस. लर्नर्स, we would discuss here Andrew Marvell and his poem to his choir mistress. Now Andrew Marvell was a metaphysical poet. He belongs to the 17th century. It was the age of Puritan age. He was born in Winstead, East Riding of Yorkshire, England on 31st of March 1621. He was the son of a clergyman whose name was also Andrew Marvell. It means his father's name was also Andrew Marvell. He was Andrew Marvell, now was called Andrew Marvell Jr. Andrew Marvell Jr. was educated at Hull Grammar School. At the age of 13, he attended Trinity College, Cambridge, where he completed his BA. He worked as an assistant for John Milton, also as secretary in the Foreign Office. In 1659, he was elected member of Parliament for Hull, an office he held until his death in August 1878. London to His Choir Mistress is one of the best known and well recognized poems of Andrew Marvell. The poem deals the conventional theme of conflict between love and time in an ironic and witty manner. Further, we will see now what is metaphysical poetry. As you can see, the word metaphysic is used to describe a concept in literature in which things are defined by something non-physical. It means metaphysical is made, word metaphysical is made up of two words. First one is meta, it means beyond, and physical means the physical world. Hence, the metaphysical denotes the meaning of things that are beyond this world. Metaphysical writing is concerned with intangible experiences and the feelings. The chief quality of metaphysical poetry is the use of elaborate figurative language, original conceits, paradoxes, and philosophical topics. Metaphysical poetry enjoyed most during the 17th century in England. In England, the 17th century was the period where metaphysical poetry was at its peak, and every poet was trying his hand in the this form of poetry, means metaphysical poetry. Now, the chief exponent of this metaphysical poetry was John Donne. As M.H. Abraham puts out, that John Dryden, in his discourse concerning satire, first time used the term metaphysics. Means John Dryden first time used the term metaphysics. Dryden stated that John Donne, his poetry affects the metaphysics. It means Donne was the poet who was the chief exponent of this form of poetry, metaphysical poetry. It means that Donne employs the terminology and obtuse arguments of the medieval scholastic philosophers. Medieval thoughts were also indulged in the poems of John Donne. Furthermore, in 1779, Samuel Johnson, in his Life of Cowley, Samuel Johnson, the next poet, in his Life of Cowley, in his book Life of Cowley, extended the term, and he explains that metaphysical for a school of poets who willingly or unwillingly followed Donne. He often organized his poem as an urgent or heated argument with reluctant mistress or intruding friends or God or death with himself. He implemented a subtle, often deliberate, outrageous logic. He was a realistic, ironic, and sometimes cynical in his treatment of the complexity of human motives, especially in the sexual relationship. Now, one thing is very clear. Metaphysical poet doesn't think that they have enough time within this world. Metaphysical poets want to utilize the present time as much as they can. So, in metaphysical poetry, you will find that there is a choir mistress, sai mistress, and his lover. Lover tries to urge his mistress, his beloved, to make the most and best use of present time. Further, chief characteristics. Now we will see what is the chief characteristics of the poem, metaphysical poetry. One of the most prominent characteristics of the movement is the spoken quality of the poetry. In this movement, which is called metaphysical poetry, metaphysical is, poetry is having certain spoken quality. It means it talks with you, it interacts with you, it asks questions, it raises questions, it gives answer, it takes answer. Something that many other writers of that time did not approve of. So it is why the metaphysical poets of that time were condemned by other poets, because other poets really understand that poem is something that can talk, that something that can't preach. Other common features include the use of colloquial diction. Here, in metaphysical poetry, very common and simple language of a common man was used for the use of artistic presentation. Philosophical exploration, new and original conceit, irony, and the relaxed use of meters. Poets whose works have been categorized as metaphysical often seek out the answer to the question such as, does God really exist, or does humankind really have a free choice, or what is the nature of reality or truth? Metaphysical poets were always in search of such questions and answer of such questions, like, does God really exist? It means we have in our minds every day at every moment, is there any God? Is there something above us who governs us? Is there really some powers above us, life above us, that governs our fate, that governs our movement? Or humankind really have a free choice? Or man are born free and every time free to perform any work, to perform any kind of work, or to think in a free way, or to do freely in a grand manner? Or what is the nature of reality or truth? Or what is the nature of reality or truth? It means, what is there which we can, it is real truth. Okay? Further, here, in metaphysical poetry, there is a theme which is called carpe diem. Okay, carpe diem. Carpe diem is the idea behind a poem that time is limited. Here in this world, we are allotted with a limited time. And within this limited range of time, we have to perform our every work, several types of work. And love making is one of them. So metaphysical poet always try to find that, always try to convince their beloved to have sexual relations with corresponding poet or his lover. Because metaphysical poet thinks often that we don't have the choice, we don't have several choices here. Because allotted time here, we have very limited number. So what we expect to do here, it should be performed as soon as possible. Now, carpe diem means seize the day. Its original meaning is the seize the day. It means that we should use and best use the present time, because present mirth has present laughter. Every time our life is decreasing. Now, what is the
use of this time, which is passed away. It is a Latin phrase from one of the Horace Odes which suggests to make the most proficient use of present time. It is the one of that we should use, we should utilize the present time in the best manner. The speaker in a Carpe Diem poem emphasizes that life is short and time is fleeting. In a Carpe Diem poem, poet always tries to suggest that time is fleeting and life is very short. So we should perform our every work, our every allotted task as soon as possible. Make hurry. Use most and best use of time. Don't be shy. Have relations. Have faith. And use most proficiently the present time. He urges his auditor, who is often a virgin and elected, change her condition to make the most of present pleasure. Now, in such type of poems, poet or lover always try to urge his beloved, who is always or mostly a virgin, reluctant virgin towards sexual intercourse, to change her condition and to make relations with the lover. Further, now we will talk about To His Choir Mistress, a poem by Andrew Marvell, Andrew Marvell belongs to the 17th century. His poems are best examples of metaphysical poetry. To His Choir Mistress is one of his best known poem and well-recognized poem in literary ages. To His Choir Mistress is a metaphysical poem by the English author and politician Andrew Marvell, most likely written in the 1650s in the midst of English interregnum, 1649 to 1660, but published posthumously in 1681. The poem was published after the death of Andrew Marvell in 1681. The poem uses Carpe Diem theme of following the example of Roman poets like Horace. It urges a young and non-respondent woman to enjoy the pleasures of life before death claims her. Indeed, the poem is an attempt to seduce the titular choir mistress. Now, poem To His Choir Mistress by Andrew Marvell is an attempt to seduce, to attract, to persuade her beloved so they can have best use of present time. It is an urge to have sexual intercourse with her lover. Further, it is text, but we have less time to describe it thoroughly, but we will discuss two or three lines only. Had we but world enough and time, this pious lady were no crime. We would sit down and think which way to walk and pass our long lost day. Here, the poet urges his beloved, lady, if we had enough space and enough time, this quietness, your shyness, it means your shyness, was never a crime, but since we have limited time, this quietness would be a crime, because time is fleeting and our precious moments are going away. So we are here to use best use of present time. We would sit down and think which way to walk and pass our long lost day. If we had enough time and space, then we would think how should we use this time in making love, by walking and passing our long day of love. Okay, two more lines. The graves are fine and private place, but none, I think, do their embrace. Here the poet says that lovers always try to find a solitary place, calm place, secluded place to make the love, making their love, performing their love actions, actually. It means lover would find solitary place, and the grave would be a best, would be the best private place for making love. Doesn't you think? You think. But none, I think, do their embrace. Where should we make our love? In a private, fine place? Grave is most secluded place within this world. But poet says there no one is going to make love. For what? Because there is the graves are only a resting place after death. Our long retired day after death. So there's no one is going to make their love for fulfillment of their love. Further, finally, Shalya, thus though we cannot make our son stand still, but we will make him run. And by here the poet urges and says, by making our love decisions, by making our love actions, we cannot stand still our son. Means we cannot stop our time. But by making our love at present moment, at present time, we would try to make him run. Means we would try to spend our time in a best way, in a best manner, in the best manner. Okay? This was the text for you. Now, ahead, we would see some themes in the poem to his choir mistress. What are the basic themes? There are several types of themes in this poem, but we have selected few themes for you. There are several themes in the poem related with time, sex, mortality, carpe diem, and the negation of ideal love. The poem also neglects the idealism of love. It means the love is not a idealistic thing, where lover is just watching the eyes of his beloved and passing his time. Metaphysical poets, love is something to use at a present time. Meet your beloved. Urge her. Respond her. Try to have in faith her. And try to make her your own by your love makings. For metaphysical poets, as soon as we meet our beloved, we should try to seduce her, to have sexual relations with her. Time is one of the major themes in the poem. It passes as it has wings. The speaker of the poem tells that every argument of his beloved would be accepted if they had enough time and space. As I have told you earlier, however, the allotted time is very short and limited. More to this, the age of youth is very short, and they would not remain the same fiery spirits once it passes. Time is antagonist of love. It takes everything away with it and leaves nothing but dust. In the poem to his choir mistress, one of the major themes is time. Here, time is presented as an enemy for lovers, because time seduces, time sucks the lover's charms, beloved's charms. As the time passes, the charm of the beloved would not remain the same. Attractiveness of his lips, his eyes, his nose, his cheeks, his neck, and several other parts of the body would not remain the same. And after the After some time, the time passes, flits very tragically. The lovers would not remain the same fiery spirits, and the passion of the love, fire of love, after a certain time would not remain same. Then what should we do? We should make the most and best use of present time. Sex is another main theme in the poem. The speaker calls sex his upper power to control the enemy at time. Now, for the speaker, sex is his upper power to control his enemy. Enemy is here. For lover, time is enemy. If there are lovers, they cannot satisfy them with 1 day, 2 days, 1 year, 2 years. They want more and more time to make their love, to express their love, to have spent time with their beloved. He addresses his beloved saying that her long preserved virginity is of no use because with the passage of time everything would turn into dust and into ashes. Now, poet says, her beloved's preserved virginity would be of no use because with the passage of time everything would turn into dust and into ashes. Mortality also plays a major role in the poem. To the speaker, humans are nothing more than dust and ashes in the vast desert of after death. On the other hand, life and especially youth is the best time to enjoy everything. Here the poet says that mortality is one of the best known part of the humans. One must die after a certain time. And therefore, youth is the best time to enjoy every pleasure of this world. And making love is one of them. As I have told you earlier, theme in the poem is a strong advocacy to seize the day. The poem is a strong advocacy for having the most and the best use of time. With the limited range of time, we should try to achieve everything. We should try to have everything. The negation of ideal love incorporates new and striking idea to the poem. Now, the negation of ideal love. Metaphysical poets totally and completely neglect the idealism of love, idealistic approaches toward love. It means where a lover is seen just watching her beloved's eyes, lips, cheeks, neck, hair, and other parts of the bodies, and doesn't try to touch any part of the body. But for the metaphysical poets, what is the difference? He always tried to have a sexual intercourse with her beloved. However, this poem denies all such notions and emphasizes the point physical relations is necessary for completion of love. The ideal notion of love and honor are mere tasks. It manifests the idea that lovers should meet and find happiness in the closeness of each other. The poem is a strong advocacy also for the manifestation of the lovers to find happiness in the closeness of each other. Poem is also a strong advocacy for what? For have sexual intercourse with each other, to be close to each other, to have relations with each other. In this way, metaphysical poets have chief concern with them to utilize in the best way the present time, because present time has present laughter. present mirth has present laughter. If we utilize present time, we would be able to defeat it. I, our arch enemy, means time. Further, so thank you. Once again, I am your new assistant professor from UPRTU, Dr. Amit Kumar Singh. I have discussed with you To His Choir Mistress, a poem by Indru Marvel, 17th century poet, metaphysical poet. I have told you what is metaphysical poetry, what is metaphysical poets, what is the chief characteristics of the metaphysical poetry, and what are the chief concerns of the metaphysical poets. Thank you once again for hearing me and watching me. In our next lecture, we will try to explain the poem completely. Thank you so much.